Apostolos, very good afternoon to everybody. I know that you are a very loyal audience and participants to Apostolos events. I respect him a lot as a person, and also I sincerely appreciate his contribution to the shipping industry all these years. He is 30, I am 40. So today, thanks for the invitation, and I have prepared something about the accidents. I have made a review where we have been and where we are now. And frankly, I don't see any improvement at all. And I will tell you why. This, we go back in 1987 with the ferry Herald of Free Enterprise, which was a roll-on, roll-off ferry, capsized outside of a Belgian port, Zeebrugge, on the night of 6 March 1987. The accident resulted in killing 193 passengers and crew of the 539 people aboard. The immediate cause of the sinking was found to be negligence by the bosun and the chief officer. Deep inside the investigation of this accident, there was a code of communication between the bosun and the chief officer. This code was when the shoes of the bosun were outside of his cabin, the bow door was closed. This night the bosun was sick, he was with fever, and he didn't go out of the cabin, so the bow door remained open. The accident marked the beginning of the ISM around 1988 and at the beginning of the 90s, where we all have been through. Next one, the Samina, who hurt also our Greek nation a lot, and hurt also the coastal shipping companies and the ships. Samina was a French-built Ropax ferry, collided on the rock off the coast of Paros on 26 September of 2000, resulting the about 82 deaths, fatalities of passengers. It was very sad, and this incident could have marked the beginning of the British Navigation Watch Alarm System, but this came a lot after, I think about 2010. Rina, on 2011, bridge team failure here, and the root cause, environmental disaster, very, very serious incidents. I can show an accident. We can measure hundreds the last 35 years in our industry with tankers, bulkers, ro-ros, all the type of ships. Very recent, in 2020, Wakasio, the bulk carrier, ran aground on a coral reef on 25th of July 2020. The ship began to leak fuel oil in the following weeks and broke apart in mid of August, as you can see in the reflected photos. The much of the oil on board Wakasio was pumped out before she broke in half. An estimated of 1,000 tons of oil spilled into the ocean. The disaster caused because the crew was seeking mobile signal. The root cause, of course, here is also a bridge team failure. The seeking of the crew for mobile signal was just the cause. Okay. After 3 years, we had the incident investigation. It was published a few days ago. This has been taken from Intercargo. NPI means negative performance indicator. You can see that all these years we are running about repeated and same accidents and incidents, collisions, allisions, and of course machinery failures, which may be caused by human element or by machinery breakdown, is on the top, and we don't know why. Enclosed spaces, we still see very serious accidents and fatalities inside enclosed spaces after all these years. We have falls from height and a trend to the pilot ladders. We had three fatalities in the west coast of the United States with two pilots and one crew member, and three more fatalities in Australia, falling by the from pilot ladders the last year, two pilots again and a crew member. Fire explosions as well, man overboard from a tanker, a chemical tanker, a few days ago off the coast of US. And we have gone through these root causes, which is the deadly dozen, as I have defined: situational awareness, alerting, fit for duty, fatigue, the communication and the code, complacency, which is still a factor that we don't know how to fight, culture, distraction, work pressure, capability, teamwork, onboard practices, and of course, what we haven't said so far about the over-salutation of seafarers from new regulations that IMO immortals made, okay? Here I have prepared something that combines everything: the causes, the seafarers, their competence, the root causes, and what we have concluded, what makes a ship unsafe. Fatigue, the multicultural clues, the communication, the code of communication that is being used on board, the complacency and lack of money, of course. We were sailing with 30 people on board, and now we are sailing with 20. Skills of the seafarers, the mental capacity, the over-salutation I've mentioned before, we put on the seafarers so much weight that they cannot lift. Okay. The company's own culture, of course, this is also a main cause. The knowledge and lack of balance between senior and junior officers, the attitude on board and the attitude of the seafarers concluded to the root causes, constant change of crew, lack of training, lack of situational awareness, inexperience, safety culture, and lack of compliance. On the other side, what makes the ship safe? Of course, the procedures, the company's philosophy, the company's dedication to safety, and what kind of crew want to employ, and how the training, and as Apostolos said before, the effectiveness of the training is purely on the trainees willing to learn, no more, no less. Professionalism, experience, and training, integrated management safety systems that we have developed so many years when the ISM code appeared, early 90s. The safety standards, the master's leaderships, the attitude, multi-skilled crew, very important also. And of course the resilience, the good maintenance regimes and practices, the continuous improvement, seafarers' competence to face problems and resolve also problems, vessel generous safety margins. This is how we understand the industry best practice. How do you understand? How do you apply on board your ships? And is it effective? This is what in Alpha think of the best practice, okay, to implement these companies' integrated management systems, understanding a task, the toolbox meetings on board, the risk assessment, the permit to work, lockout, tagout procedures, the stop work authority. When we apply this procedure, we have saved many lives, the supervision and the teamwork. Best practice, we also absorb and we have been informed from all these third parties and organizations, the IMO Immortals, BIMCO, Intertango, Intercargo, AMSA, US Coast Guard, Paris MOU, EMSA, Tokyo MOU. You are aware. The important thing here is how you take advantage of this information. This, okay, you didn't fall asleep. This is good news. Okay, thank you very much.